Hey everybody, welcome back to Skylanders Giants for 3DS. Let's head to the next level. Actually, before we do that, I'm going to be using Tree Rex. You notice he's the regular colored one, the red and green one. I used the gnarly Tree Rex in a previous video, but this is the one that actually comes with the 3DS version. And Series 1 Whamshell, and he's a water Skylander. The two elements here, it's water and life, so I picked these two. He has a mace, you can do combos with it, and he can shoot out starfish out of his mace. Pretty cool. Alright, let's talk to Flynn here, and... Oh wait, nope, can't go there yet. Okay, and this level is called the Windy Dunes, and there should be 5 hats here, if I remember right. I checked before I went to here, but then I had to step away to grab some these two Skylanders, so... I think that's the right amount, 5. Okay. This level actually looks pretty cool with the sandstorm going on. Got those tornadoes too. Those pigs in there, you have to rescue. Those are the ones that we have to rescue. Okay. Now, there are exactly 8 Skylanders from the first game. Well, I should say 8 unique Skylanders. There's some variants. Anyway, 8 unique Skylanders that did not get a Series 2 figure. One from each element. One of them, the water element one is Whamshell. He does not have a Series 2 equivalent. But, you know, thankfully the Series 1 figures are compatible with Skylanders Giants, so it's not a big deal. It's just, it doesn't have an equivalent. And this is actually, this attack, it's pretty interesting because it looked like the starfish surrounded him. I did not know that they did that. Okay, I'm going to let you guys know ahead of time. There's a lot of things I'm going to say in this playthrough that will be repeated in the Wii U version playthrough, if that's up already. If you probably noticed that, if not, then now you know. The main reason is just because, you know, not everybody's interested in 3DS version, so I want that information known for anybody watching the Wii U one. But if you're watching both of them, which is actually really cool, because like I said, these two games are completely different, then yeah, you have the knowledge and you get to hear it again. There's nothing over here. I wasn't sure, I just wanted to double check. I used Whamshell quite a bit in the first game on the Wii. And Tree Rex I've used a lot on this game and on the console. Now the thing is though, I had 2 Tree Rexes. He comes with every version of the game. Like the, if you just buy the game, like starter pack or portal owners pack. That one, oh crap, I did not mean to do that. The portal owners pack is like a pack that comes with just Tree Rex and the game, no portal, because you can reuse the portal from the first game for this one too. Any version. Anyway, so I had 2 Tree Rexes and managed to sell that one. I think I mentioned a couple videos ago that I had the gnarly Tree Rex, and what I did was I replaced the gnarly Tree Rex in that pack with the other Tree Rex I had, the extra one, and sold that on Amazon. So now I have 1 Tree Rex and the variant. Oh crap, you know what? I don't think I was supposed to do that. That seemed like that was the way to go, so let me check over here first, then I'll move on. It looks like you can head back because there's steps there. This level is actually pretty big, so there's a lot of exploration to do. It's down here. Oh wait, nope, I don't want to go in there. I'm used to, on the console, the water Skylanders can swim, or not really swim, but they float on the surface. Kind of used to doing that. Let's open that up there. Oh, hat. Okay, let me go back up here and then once I grab what I want, I'll go on the portal. Or what, the teleporter, whatever. Okay, that's the way that I came from. Looks like I can go up here too. Woo! Okay, yeah, let's step on here. Oh, I just brought it back. Okay, that was like a shortcut. Alright. Let's grab what I can here. You know what? Screw it. I'm just gonna keep going. Now, this guy right here might be a bit of a problem. By that, I mean, I could just pelt him to death with starfish. What a way to go. Death by starfish. Oh, crap. There's a piggy in this tornado. The other thing is, like, depending on what the pig is, you can either get it without taking any damage, or you're gonna have to take some damage to get it. The timing there was just kind of coincidental. I managed to grab the pig without getting hurt. Oh, I don't want to fall off. There's another pig here. So I need 7 more. What else do we need to do? Oh. I haven't seen any gates yet. We're still pretty early in the level, though. Wait a minute. Did I see something down there? Oh, it's just a jar. Okay, let's just go in. Just wanted to make sure I didn't miss anything important. Okay, but like I mentioned, there are 8 Skylanders that did not get a Series 2 repose for Skylanders Giants. Besides Whamshell, it's Whamshell, Camo, Ornado, Boomer, Dino Rang, Voodude, Sunburn. Is that all of them? I don't remember how many elements I just named there. Tech was Boomer, Fire. Water, Tech. Undead. Who's the Undead? Oh, Ghost Roaster. I think that was the last one. Actually, the only Adventure Pack one that got a repose was Slam Bam. He is actually one of the few I am missing. I do not have Series 2 Slam Bam yet. Right now, it is like the end of January when this is recorded, and as far as I know, he's the rarest single pack, like non-variant one to find right now. Which is unlucky for me because I don't have him. I should have bought him when I had the chance, I just didn't realize how rare he would be. For a while, Whamshell was the hardest one to find. I actually was able to pre-order him from Amazon, so I didn't have to wait in line, I just had to wait till like mid-June, till he arrived, till Amazon got the stock for him to arrive. You know, as of this video, I've only ever seen Whamshell in a store twice. Once was like at a Best Buy, I found one. There's one just sitting there. And the other was like a little after Thanksgiving at Toys R Us. They had like 5 or 6 of them. If I remember right, they got like a shipment of just Whamshells, which is pretty cool for anybody that didn't have one yet. He's still kind of difficult to find. Just a lot of people didn't. He was the last non-variant one to be released, so I guess not a lot of people got him immediately. Or knew that he was released, because he was kind of quietly released. It wasn't like a big release, it was just him. Well, no, he came out with Ornado and Camo too, but those two are part of like a triple pack. But Whamshell was only released on his own. Oh, there's a piggy in here. So I need a few more of those. Okay, I'm gonna take out these two because they're very annoying. Okay. Okay, so that's 300 coins collected there. Before we move on, I'm gonna go through the Watergate. What else am I missing here? One more giant area and 3 more pigs, and then the other elemental gate. Which I'm really hoping I didn't miss somehow. Now this guy's gonna try to snipe me, so I'm gonna get him before he starts messing around. Okay. Let me check along this beach, see if there's anything here hidden here. Oh, nothing? Really? That seems like a prime spot for something hidden. Okay, I actually don't remember how many hats I collected either, so... Oh. I thought that was like deep water. The only thing is Whamshell's not a very good jumper. This guy. He's like the fake Eruptor, but like a cactus version. It's like gas, or poison gas, or something like that that he shoots out of his hands. He's basically just a reskin version of the fake Eruptor, or the black Eruptor that shoots out oil. It's the cactus Eruptor. Whoa! Those fall fast, and like I said, Whamshell is not a very good jumper, so... Okay, there. Now this part looks very fun, doesn't it? Holy crap, this is all going so fast. Just die! Jeez. There you go. Oh, whoa. Kind of hesitated there. Okay, so for this part I'm gonna snipe him out. Oh, I love this attack. The only thing is I can't really aim this that well. I'm trying to go for this guy right here. Out of range. Okay. No, die. Okay. Alright. So... We still have quite a bit to do. It feels like I missed a lot already. I still have the other giant area, more pigs, and then the other elemental gate. Actually, we're still in the water area. That's right. Forgot about that. There's another hat. It's kind of unfortunate they don't tell you how many hats you've collected so far. You just kind of have to remember how many you collected on your own. Oh no! Oh. The tornado pushed me off. Right, I'm gonna move away from this area though. You know, this is gonna be really fun in the time challenge. I definitely have to bring somebody fast and one that can deal with those harder hitting enemies. Wait, is there something in that tornado? Nope, nothing. Okay, let's get out of here. Alright, we have a tornado up ahead with a pig in it. Okay, cool. And there's nothing hidden behind there? Wow. Okay. I'm still missing two pigs. I'd really hate to come back to this level if I missed anything. Those guys are waiting. Whoa, there's so many enemies over there. Whoa. Still missing two pigs. I'm gonna just go up to where they are. Nice. Alright, let's open this up, get Whamshell some experience points. Okay. Really hoping I just didn't miss anything. Oh, there's a life. Whoa! I glitched through the floor. That was crazy. We've actually seen a number of glitches in the playthrough already. Nothing severe, it's just... It's always interesting to see a glitch. It's even better when they don't affect gameplay that much. I think the only one that I remember was a couple episodes ago when the camera went crazy and the touchscreen stopped working for some reason. Seems pretty straightforward so far. Crap. Ramshell's not that great at jumping, but he's better than Tree Rex. There we go. Not too bad so far. This part looks very fun, though. Alright. That wasn't too bad. Just gotta land on this. Jump up there. Alright, and made it. Cool. Alright, so what are we... Okay, we have one giant area and two more pigs. I just pray that I did not miss them anywhere. Get away from me. Okay. Right, that opened that teleporter up. Wondering if there's something just hidden behind that waterfall, but nope. Alright, where are we going now? That is a big jump. Okay. You know what? Take out these guys first. Out of here. Oh, there's another pig. Cool. The giants almost always get hit by... Oh, wait. That's a giant area right there. Oh, wait. No, it's not. Never mind. False alarm. Look like Tree Rex's head. If you notice, the giant areas have his head on him. Probably since he's like the main... Oh, here it is right here. There's like a feat of strength from the console version. Holy crap, he's getting annihilated right now. It's these archers, they're... The arrows that they shoot hit really hard. Grab that. There we go. I mean, the giant areas usually are like the equivalent of the feat of strength. You don't get a fancy cutscene thing, but... You know, only the giants can do it, so basically the equivalent of that. Alright, we got everything, hopefully. Like I said, there should have been 5 hats, I think, here. 4 or 5. Okay, probably just make it to the end here, and that should be it. But it's like I was saying, the time challenge here is going to be ridiculous, I'm sure. If I remember right, it is. It's pretty impressive. You can see like most of the level on the bottom of this screen here. Right, I think that's it. Let's grab this propeller and get out of here. I like how most of the levels are pretty long like that. I mean, it's almost like the console version chapters. Well, the chapters on there are actually a little bit longer the first time through. Some of those are like 30, 40 minutes, but if you combine the first time through and the time challenge, you know, it's... They're pretty lengthy. Okay, so there's one hat. The wizard hat, that one's cool. Alright, so this is 4. Okay, I got 4 hats. I thought there were 5, so I probably missed one. I'll double check, though. Okay, this is through the water gate, and this is where the last hat is. I wanted to show everybody exactly where to get it. You can actually see this spinning rock over here, and it leads to the last hat. Totally missed this the first time. There we go. Alright, so I'm going to skip ahead to the end of the level, and we can see which hat that is. And I think it's the tiki hat or something like that. Okay, and that was the last hat. Now we're going to skip ahead a little bit here and start the time challenge. Alrighty, so I switched out Whamshell for Chop Chop since Chop Chop is a little bit faster than Whamshell. And let's go back here and do the time challenge. And then we'll finally be done with this level. And this time challenge might be a little tough because, as you saw, this is one of the longer levels. Up to this point, it probably is the longest level so far. So, pretty much, I'm having to have to run through, except for, like, you know, parts where you have to stop, like the enemy gates, stuff like that. No detours, I don't need to collect anything else in the level. I've gotten everything else, so I'm just gonna keep running. Alright. Chop Chop, this is Series 2 Chop Chop, and he's been upgraded quite a bit. I've used him both on this version and on the Wii U. Okay, he's actually really good. In the first game, on the first console game, I should say, he was just okay. He wasn't that great, but he's gotten some buffs on the console version, especially his Wow Pow is actually really good. So, you know, he's better this time around. In my opinion, he's always been good on the handheld version, though. Like, he's had, like, I guess he has combinations of attacks from both of his upgrade paths from the console version, so, you know, that actually makes him really a well-rounded fighter here. Okay, 3 minutes left. I might... Okay, sorry for the interruption there. UPS dropped by. Alright. I don't remember what I was talking about. Yeah, that kind of threw me off. Anyway. Yeah. Oh, I think I was talking about something like how long this level is. Alright. Well, if I wasn't, then I'll talk about it now. Yeah, this level has a lot of parts to go through, as you saw in the initial run. And trying to get through here, like, unscathed. I have to take out these two. Oh, and that one dropped a stopwatch. Oh, both of them did. That'll really help out, because for this level, you probably need as much time as you can get. I'm not even sure if I'm, like, at least halfway through just yet. Okay, but anyway, as you saw on the level select screen, oh, and Callie mentioned it too. The next world is like a theme park, and it's actually a pretty interesting world. And let's go through here. Oh crap, I fell off. It's not good. I don't know if I would have rather just fallen off completely, because they might start you out in some crappy spot. I do have a feeling, though, that I'll have to... Oh, no, 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 no. Yeah, I fell off. That dropped me off in the middle. Anyway. Oh, that was towards the top. But, yeah, I might have to go through this level again, because I've wasted a lot of time already. I still haven't even gotten to the life gate. Yeah, let me try taking him out. Hopefully he'll drop something. Nope. Archers, maybe? Come on, you gotta drop something. And drop a thing. That's great. Okay, this guy might. The fake Eruptor. Oh, yes, he did. 15 seconds. That's the only one that was dropped in that big frenzy. Okay. I think if I can make it to that life gate with a good amount of time, I could probably make it, but that's actually at the top of this part here. I only have a little over a minute, and I don't know why I just did that. Thankfully, that wasn't far from the checkpoint. Okay, for these enemies, I'm gonna try to take them out because I'm sure somebody's gonna drop something. There's a fruit basket. Oop, time. Okay, here we go. These two have to drop something. Oh, there's three of them. Nothing, nothing, and nothing. Wow, waste of time. Alright. I know at the top of this cliff you do have to fight the enemies up here. Watch out for this poison gas here. Okay, there's a stopwatch, and there's another one. That's another cool thing. Chop Chop on this version, when he does his jump, oh, double jump, he does like this spinning slice. It's actually really useful. I took out one of those enemies with that. Alright. About a minute left now. Oh, sweet. Leveled up. Hopefully these guys... Oh, yep, he dropped one. Just one, though. That only bought me a little bit of time. I'm getting there, though. I'm getting there. A lot of these guys here. Come on, one of you drop something. Jeez. Alright, I'm gonna use Jetpack, I guess. He seems to be a little bit faster than Chop Chop. I think I'm getting kind of close to the exit. Oh yeah, it's right there, it's right there. Just the propeller. And that's the exit once you grab that. Yes. Alright. Alright, so I made it with a little bit of time to spare, but that's all you need, so I'm okay with that. Alright, so once we're done with this screen, you can't really skip it. Yeah, you can't. It goes by pretty quick, though. We're gonna head back to the ship, and then I'll end the video, and then I'm going to switch to some different Skylanders, and we'll head to the next world. Alright, everybody. Thanks for watching. See you next time.